Hello everyone. Let us see a program on strong number. Okay, so what is a strong number and how we write a program in C language? Let us see. So here, this is an example for a strong number where we accept a number and every individual digit factorial will be added. And if the sum and the original number both are equal, then it is called as a strong number. So if you observe in a picture where and 145 is a number where every digit of that number is separated 5 factorial plus 4 factorial plus 1 factorial. Then the answers are 124 and 120. If you add them, we are getting 140. So the accepted number and sum both are equal. So this is an example for strong number. Okay. So this is a process we are doing it. We are taking a digit, we are factorialing it, and the factorial answers are summed up and comparison, then we'll decide whether it is a strong number or not. So here is a simple algorithm using which we'll write a program. Okay. So same steps like reverse of a number, sum of the digits and Armstrong number. The only one step will be differed where we do the factorial of a individual digit. Okay. So let us write a program. Okay. So let us write a program here. We'll accept a number. We'll accept a number. And using printf, we'll ask the user to enter a number. And using scanf, we accept. Of course, we know that they both are formatted IO. So once we accept a number, now we want to calculate the. We want to calculate sum of factorial of individual digits. So how we do is very simple. We take each and every digit of the number, we separate and we will calculate a factorial. So we are storing it in a temporary variable, the original number, so that in the last we can compare. And we initialize the sum is equals to 0. So we declare all these variables, temp, sum, and also we need a digit which is to be separated, remainder. Okay. So what is the first step? As usual, like a reverse of a number and the sum of the digits number program, where we extract the rightmost digit using remainder is equal to temp mod 10. What will happen? Extract the digit, rightmost digit, okay, rightmost digit using mod. Okay, so using one. Be clear. So what we do, we calculated, we got an a digit. Now we have to calculate what? Here, we have to calculate the factorial. The factorial of digit, what you have extracted. Once we calculate a factorial, then what we'll do? We will sum is equal to sum plus the answer of the factorial. So we will add. So we know already how to calculate a factorial. In the previous session, we have discussed like this is a way to calculate a factorial. This is a way to calculate a factorial where we will do 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 up into n. So we can write it using a normal way or a recursive way also. We can calculate a recursion also. Okay. So let us write a simple way only how to calculate a digit factorial. So we want to calculate remainder factorial. So we write a simple program for I is equal to 1, I less than or equal to remainder I plus plus. So what we do, we will calculate the whatever digit extracted, which is stored in a remainder. For that remainder, we are calculating the factorial. So factor is into fact into I. So we need a temporary variable here, which is nothing but fact is equal to 1. Once we come out of the fact, we will add. Are we clear? So we have to declare one more variable called as fact. So once we complete it, then the program is ready. So then once we complete this process, after coming out of the loop, we want to compare if the sum, if it is equals to the original number, which is num. Okay, if both are equal, then what we say, printf entered number. What is that entered number, which is num, is strong number. So it is a strong number, the string strong number. So it is always advisable to type a program and check rather than copying and pasting, please, all the students. Okay, so printf, even though if you get an errors also, you can tell not an Armstrong, strong number, not a strong number, please. So all these Armstrong number, strong number, perfect number, and the reverse number, all almost logic is same, only one step will be different. So here, what we are doing here, once again, if you cover, so we have done what? We have accepted a number, we have stored it in a temporary variable, until the temp greater than zero, we are extracting a digit, for that digit, we are calculating a factorial, and that factorial is added to the sum. So repeatedly, we are doing it, and the fact must be initialized before the value. So before calculating a factorial, we have to initialize, not outside. If you initialize outside, only one digit is initialized. So we repeatedly calculating a factorial. That's why we have to initialize before every factorial calculation. Be clear. So let us save the program. And so we have to declare one more variable I. So most frequent error is undeclared variables that we got. Now it is getting corrected. Yes. So let us compile and run. Now, if at all, if you enter 143 and check it whether it is an Armstrong number or. Okay, so let us check. We have accepted the number, temp greater than zero. And the most important step we forgot, we have to temp is equal to temp by 10, because we have to remove the digit, otherwise, we'll go to infinity loop. So, temp is equal to temp by d. What is this? Remove the digit. So, whenever every loop, three properties, initialization, condition checking, and increment, decrement. So, in this loop, while loop, this is increment and decrement. So, that's why we are getting an infinite loop. Okay. So, please try to learn the debugging process and error correction process also. Okay. So, now let us enter a number 143. Then 143 is not a strong number. Okay. Now, which number is a strong number? Let us see here. So, let us enter 145 as per the example without wasting a time. Okay. So, let us go back to the program. Okay. And try to compile. 145 is a strong number. So, why are we getting a garbage value? Because always after the printf, we have to give the, so every percentile d will be substituted with a variable name. So this is, that's why we are, okay. So, save the program, compile and run. 145 is an Armstrong number. Sorry, strong number, strong. Okay, so you can observe what is happening also. You can write like, you can write here printf. What you are doing, you are adding factorial to sum is equal to what? Percentile d. So which factorial are you adding? So you are adding a remainder factorial to sum. Both we can display. Okay, so that we want to see the output process, how it is getting happened. So please observe here, first to 5 factorial is added to the sum, then 4 factorial is added to the sum, and 1 factorial is added to the sum, then it is a strong number. Okay, so whereas if you compile once again and enter 129, then 9 factorial and 2 factorial and 1 factorial, the answer is different, then it is not an Armstrong number. Are we clear? So this is a strong number program, which is a very, very easy program where we are doing simple thing, similar to reverse sum of the digits and perfect number programs. Simply separate the digit from a number, calculate a factorial and add it to the sum. So using this simple three steps, we are calculating the program. Okay. So let us revise the process what we have done. So we have you see here, taking a digit, factorial and sum. That's what we have showing in a simple algorithm. Accept a number, repeat the steps. Which are steps are what? Extract the digit, calculate the factorial of the digit, add it to the sum and remove the digit from the number, which we got an error in the program while typing. Are we clear? So once we complete the loop, we'll come out. So here we are using two loops. One outer loop is what? Calculating a strong number logic, whereas inner loop is doing a calculating a factorial of individual digit. Okay. So then we'll compare and we'll say whether it is a strong number or not. So this is about a strong number program. Okay. We have written and executed a program. Okay. So thank you so much, people, everybody. So please keep on typing a program in live and execute and check the corrections, errors, and learn in live only. Don't copy and paste and execute the program. Thank you. See you in the next programs. Okay. Have a great day. Thank you.